an important tree native to Southern Europe, North Africa and Asia Minor, but also cultivated to other parts of Europe, like the British Isles, is the Mediterranean hackberry. Its scientific name is Celtis australis. It is also known as Southern nettle tree or European nettle tree. I had first seen this tree a few years ago while on a road trip in central Greece. It was growing at the edges of the fields that were next to the road. But as I didn't have time, I overlooked it, leaving my acquaintance with it for another time. So recently I had the luck to find it again near Athens and decided to have a better look at it. The nettle tree, or melikoukia as it is known in Greece, is a deciduous large tree with a height that can reach up to 25 meters. Its bark is soft grey that develops very characteristic corky warts with aging. New branches are sparsely fluffy or smooth. The leaves, 4 to 10 centimeters long, are narrowly egg-shaped to broadly lance-shaped, pointed with serrated edges. They bear a distant resemblance to the leaves of the stinking nettles, and this explains the common name nettle tree. The small greenish flowers grow solitary or in small groups, making their appearance along with the leaves. The fruit is a spherical berry 7 to 10 millimeters, initially green, then yellow, that ends with ripening in October in a very dark blue-purple coloration. Its habitat is in forests, field edges and streams. It can be found up to 800 meters altitude. It is a tree resistant to air pollution and can live up to 1000 years. The berries are sweet and can be eaten raw or cooked. In times of famine, it was even used instead of sugar. From the seeds that are edible, a sweet oil is extracted. The leaves and fruits have astringent and stomachic properties. The first ones are collected at the beginning of summer and dried for future use. The fruit, especially before it is fully ripe, is considered more effective. A decoction of both its leaves and fruits are used for treatment of anemia, heavy menstruation, postmenstrual bleeding, colic, and abdominal pain. The leaves were also used in folk medicine to reduce stress and, along with fruits, to lower cholesterol. Lastly, but not least, the inside of the bark was used for liver problems. Its wood is solid, tight, elastic and waterproof, useful in turning and ship building. It was also used to make toys, flutes and drums. In France, from the branches they used to make hay forks and whips. The use of hackberries as food has been very widespread since prehistoric times. This has been testified by archaeological excavations all around the world. For example, in the Zhukutian caves in China, a site with prehistoric habitation dating up to 200,000 years ago, in the Meadowcroft rock shelter in Pennsylvania, a site inhabited since 19,000 years ago, and in the cave of Theopeter in Greece, where many seeds of hackberries, among others, were consumed by Mesolithic people 9,000 years ago. The Indians had different ways of eating them. One of them was to mash the fruits by making a paste which they then wrapped around the stick and baked on the fire. Others mix this paste with fat before cooking. Personally, as you see here, because it has very little flesh and a large stone, I like to clean the flesh from each fruit and in the end, after I have collected the small quantity, to knead it into small balls and consume them. It is an exercise of patience, but at the end the result is very tasty. Something between black tea and dates. It is interesting to note that the aroma of its flesh reminds me of the smell of the hemp sacks. Perhaps by no means accidental, as the nettle tree belongs according to a botanical classification to the cannabinoid family. An easier way to consume, and much faster, is to make a drink. In this case, I mash the whole fruit and add a little water. Shake and drink. The taste is very acceptable, I would say mild sweet. The nice thing about these fruits is that they can be consumed directly from the tree, without any treatment. In addition, they are of great nutritional importance, as they have a high content of proteins, fats and carbohydrates, as well as phenols, tocopherols, carotenoids and minerals. In terms of fatty acid composition, the seeds of this fruit contain mainly linoleic acid, with the remaining being oleic acid, palmitic acid and stearic acid. All these facts make it a very important food in a state of survival, as it could possibly replace a regular meal under difficult situations.
It is interesting to mention here that some researchers believe that the lotus fruits eaten by the companions of Odysseus on the island of the lotus eaters are probably these small fruits.
(clears throat) If you have any other ideas on how to prepare the fruits, leave a comment below. And if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.